Welcome to Bible 180 Psalms, the Psalms which are poems and songs are unique. Much of the scripture is written so that people can learn from the Lord or listen to Him. However, the Psalms were written to be sung or spoken to the Redeemer of Israel. However, they are more than simply a way to express ourselves. On top of that, they are a way for our hearts and minds to grow in our appreciation of the Lord and for holy attitudes and appetites to be born within us. We don't have the time to speak about everything in the middle, so we got to talk about the beginning and the end. Psalm 1 says, God blesses the one who is not wicked but delights in God's instruction, and Yahweh promises to protect the righteous. Psalm 2 tells us how God will protect the righteous. The nations rage and splutter, but they will one day stutter before the true king. The wicked's attempts to undermine God's plan and his king will be laughable. The last five Psalms all end with hallelujah. Hallelujah is not a statement, but an exhortation or command. Praise Yahweh. Psalms are wonderful and helpful for all Christians to pray, and they cover about every human emotion and concern. As we pray the Psalms, these attitudes start to seep into our souls, transforming our hearts and minds to be more like and to long for the things we ought to be like and longing for. There are Psalms where we admit our sins, like Psalm 51, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me, or Psalm 130, if you, O Lord, kept a record of sins, O Lord, who could stand? But with you there is forgiveness, therefore you are feared. There are Psalms about lament or justice, crying out for God to rule in His people's favor or to see and stop the injustice or misery of His people. Psalm 35, contend, O Lord, with those who contend with me. Fight against those who fight against me. Sometimes they're quite bitter and even ask that God would punish those who are willfully opposing God's plan and people. Other Psalms proclaim the majesty and the saving power of God. Psalm 136 recounts the many proofs that His love endures forever. Some psalms simply declare the wonders of creation. Psalm 145 says, the eyes of all look to you, O Lord, and you give them food at the proper time. So the psalms are also focused on the Christ, which means God's anointed King of Israel. God's plan of salvation is not just some whimsical hope, but will be specifically fulfilled by the Christ of Yahweh. In many cases, the psalms are specifically written by or pointing to King David, which is why I can't emphasize enough that Jesus is the true Son of David and the subject of the psalms. He is the only one who will be truly righteous and fulfill the instructions and the will of God as we are taught in the Psalms. He is also the anointed king who will laugh at those who try to undo God's plan as he squashes sin, death, and the devil like the pests that they are. He is furthermore the triune God that is to be praised for all the wonders, works, and salvation he has fulfilled and won for God's people. Hallelujah.